Good morning, students. Welcome back to the online classes of KBR Academy. Today I am going to discuss about class 7, civics, lesson 1, democracy and equality. You know, this democracy is a combination of two Greek words. Demo. Demo means people, and krasi, or you can say kratos, means rule of the people. So that's why the democracy is a combination of rule of the peoples. And equality means all are equal in the eyes of law without any discrimination on the name of language, caste, creed, etc. So first of all, we should clarify the meaning of democracy. I have already told about the democracy is a combination of two Greek words. One is demo and second one is krato. Demo means people and krato means rule of the people. By combination of demos and krasi, it called the rule of the people. That's why in democracy, the people power is most, because people choose their candidates by casting their valuable votes. And second point is history of democracy. From where did the democracy arise? We shall discuss here. The democracy arise from the Athens. You see, the assembly of the ancient city of Athens. Means democracy is come from is origin in Athens. Second one is the Roman Senate mark, one of the first states in the evolution of the democratic states. In a Roman Senate, it is also described that to introduce first stage in the evolution of the democratic system. Means people choose this democratic system very much, because in the early time there is a monarchy, oligarchy, dictatorships, authoritarianisms. So people decline that form of government and try to choose this democracy form of government, because it is the government where you can say about and we can express our thought and feeling to the government, and you have the right to information and also whatever government is done. But in the early form of government, monarchy, that there is a rule of kings. In the oligarchy, two or three people run the government. And third one, dictatorship, just like Hitler, he can do anything, cannot ask anything from other people. So that's why most of the people decline that form of government and try to choose this democratic form of government, because it is a good form. It is a only their government which have the right to expression our thought, feeling, etc. And the people have the right by universal franchise to cast their valuable votes. Third, the feudal systems in the Europe was characteristics by the absence of the democratic spirit of government. You know, feudal system also thought in the mind to take democratic spirit in the life of the people, because in the feudal system, all the common people are deprived from the societies. They have no any land, they are landless workers. But in a feudal system, realize that there should be need of a democratic spirit of government. Fourth one is the American War of Independence against British colonialism was followed by the establishment of the democratic system in the USA. You know, USA also was under the British government. So after when the British become independent, they think in the mind to choose the democratic form of government. So this points key highlight that the democratic form of government is the most suitable form of government in the world. Last one, the French society was based on the principle of equality, liberty and fraternity. You know, equality, all are equals in the eyes of laws. Liberty means freedoms, and fraternity means brotherhood. If you do any work in an equality, by following the freedoms and fraternity, we can choose any form of government in a very good way. And this is a lasting, long-lasting form of government, where it can elections will be held after 5 years, and it is one of the most form of important form of government today in the entire world. Think that there should be a democratic form of government. Okay, I think all of you understood it. Thank you. Have a nice day.